Hi, in this video, I'm going to explain what is CAD customization. This is very important for anybody looking for high salaried job or a good career growth or any company looking for maximum productivity. Some work can be done 100 times, 1000 times faster. So that I'm going to explain with one real project work. Please listen carefully till the end of the video. And anyone who listen this video can benefit because there is a huge demand as of now. So basically CAD customization is nothing but you write some program. Okay, it's like a developing a software. Okay, add in or plug in a small software. Okay, so I'm going to show some sample. See, this is some 5 lines of program that creates 5 layers in AutoCAD. The layer name will be depending on some object, and also it will end with product number, type, finish. So this creates 5 layers in AutoCAD. And here is some code that assigns the color. So if the object is a panel, it will assign white color. Or if the object is a table or work surface, it will assign the color magenta. So something like that, what you want, how you want the drawings to be created. So you will be writing it in a program. Now this program is already written. And what this program will do, I'm going to explain quickly. So this program will do, it will create AutoCAD drawings automatically. How it creates, there is a Revit, Autodesk Revit is one software where you create a building drawings or any furniture, interior designing kind of drawings. So this is a Revit family file. So you have 2 3D geometry in Revit, and this is some table screen and this is a table top, and each product comes with many varieties. For example, this table top comes in 3 varieties. One will be 600 by 1200 and melamine material. Another is 800 by 1200 veneer. Another is some 700 by 1800. This is sliding and this is non-sliding. So something, it's a different varieties. And you can simply copy paste and you can change the size if you are creating, if you want to create a new variety. Okay. Similarly for this, how many types we want, that is given here. Now, so this is information. This is the input. There is a 3D geometry, how the geometry should look and what is the size, what is the material, that all information is in the notepad. So instead of here, you can also have the informations from Microsoft Excel, from a database or anything. Okay, so we have the program and we have the input. Now I'm going to run some add-ins within Autodesk Revit and that will automatically create my AutoCAD drawings. So I'll close this. I open a Revit. Also I'll keep it AutoCAD. So this is AutoCAD empty drawings and you can see live how it is creating here. And I also keep this notepad file open so you can also watch and how many drawings are created. And I'll keep it in a lists mode so it will be easy to understand. So we know. So here is the Revit. I'll just close everything if it is. Okay. So now actually I'm ready to execute this program. All right, so I'm going to my own add-ins. I kept it name as afeesworth.com just to for advertisement purpose, but you can keep any meaningful name here. So I'm just clicking that and it is asking where is your information. So I'm telling that it is in desktop, Feesworth training, CAD customization, test files. This is for testing purpose or demo purpose, Revit to AutoCAD. That is exactly this location. Okay, here is the information and output also I wanted in this particular folder. So I want to export in imperials or metric, you can choose. I'm choosing metric now. Just click export. That's it. So it's opening that file in Revit. It does some work before exporting. No, it has to do some work, then only the layers and colors can come here properly. and it's doing everything automatically. See here, already two drawings are created, and you can see live it is. For each variety, it will create one 2D drawing and one 3D drawings. So totally we have 3 + 3 = 6 type, and each type two drawings. That means totally 12 drawings it's supposed to create. And already it has created 3 + 3 = 6 = 7 and 8. And it's also creating the backup file, but after completion of all the work, it will automatically delete all the backup file. And it will also create one report, means how many drawings are created at what time. If there is any error in between in one particular size, if it is unable to create, so you can easily rectify that error. So that also I'll show you just after this. Now it may complete anytime. Okay, it's already completed. So, and all the backup files got deleted, and 12 drawings are created. This is that log report. So it started today, 22 March, and these are the two files, and for each file, these are the 12 items it has created. So this is before exporting this file and after exporting this file. So in case if there is any error after this, so I will get a clear understanding on that. So after exporting this particular type, it got error, means what is wrong, that we can go and rectify it. Now where is that created file? So these all created drawings, I have kept it in such a way that, you know, P is for a plan 2D drawings and T is for 3D drawings. I just want to open some 3D drawings quickly. Just open it from here. So this is 3D and this is 2D. And I'll just open, see, it created the geometry. See, just a line, and also it made a block with attributes. It also created some layers. Okay, I'll maximize AutoCAD. So it has created, it done a lot of work. So it created some layer, it automatically assigned the color. Because it is work surface, we have seen in the program, it will assign magenta color. Okay. So manually, if you have to create in AutoCAD, where you have geometry in one software or the information in some format, it may be ProE file or NX file or Revit file, or it may be in, available in database. So it is reading all the information and automatically creating the AutoCAD drawings here. The same thing you can apply any CAD softwares. It may be NX customization, CATIA customization, Team Center customization, or Inventor customization, and Creo customization. The concept, the logic is same. If you know one language properly, and all you have to do is just the tool and how to interact with that tool. That is called application programming interface. So the API, for example, to create the layer, and we have seen we have to type something layers.add. So that layers.add will create the layer. That is what you have to learn in this course. So how do you create layer? Means layers.add. Maybe in some software, layers.create. In some software, it may be in different method. So how to extrude? How to create the layer? How to create the circle? Whether to give center point first or radius first, what second? So this is what you have to learn. It is not difficult. If you can spend 1 to 2 months time, daily about 2 hours, and one or two projects, if you can do successfully, then you can enjoy this career. Because right now, there are so many software engineers, computer science people, they learn all programming language, database and everything. But they are not learning CAD, 2D, 3D seriously. And there are a lot of mechanical engineers and civil engineers, they learn all CAD, 2D, 3D software, but nobody is learning this programming. And so you should have a knowledge on programming, you should have knowledge on the tools like AutoCAD, ProE, CATIA, and also you should have knowledge on the API. So these three things, like three different courses it is, if you do, then you can easily customize on this. Look at here, you save so much time. If 1,000 drawings to be created, you have to appoint somebody for 2-3 months, or that may be not enough. For daily 10 drawings means In 1 year, you can make only 3,000 drawings. Not even 3,000 drawings if you consider all the holidays. But here 3,000 drawings can be created in 1 day. But to write that program, maybe you have to spend 1 week time or 1 month time. But it is really worth. Okay, so I hope you like this video. And if you really want to take up this course or you want to see more, then you can contact in our website, feesworth.com. Thank you.